There's so many hungry, hurting people during this holiday season. So many people having to choose between heeding and eating. And New Life Evangelistic Center is working to be there because of those of you that are caring and sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, the center that's on the front lines, the last major walk-in shelter in Mid-America, the place that people come to when they're hurting. Your involvement is very important. Be sure you stay tuned and meet just a few of the multitudes of people you're helping on a daily basis. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. There's so many people that are coming to New Life Evangelistic Center and that are facing some real critical needs. Are you one of those that are having to choose between heeding and eating, trying to scrape up enough money to get enough food?
Yes, sir.
What are some of the problems you're facing?
I'm facing a whole lot of rent right now.
Is it?
That I don't have the money for.
And they keep raising the rent costs, don't they?
Right.
And then if they end up, it's called gentrification. They're trying to make it more and more for the gentry, for the rich.
Right.
And then when you can't afford it anymore and you get put out on the street, they're trying to shut down our shelter, the last major walk-in shelter. What do you think of that?
I think that's bad, and I think everybody should come together and talk up to save the building.
And we're going to continue to do that. We're going to continue to fight to help the people. We're going to continue to feed the hungry as long as we can. What are you facing at this time?
Shelter.
Are you really?
Yes, I am.
Mm-hmm. It's really tough for the people right now, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
So
yes.
A lot of people that are hungry, hurting, not like she indicated, trying to pay the rent bill.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But we can. We can have peace, and it's tough. In the middle of the trials and tribulations, having that peace, that knowing that God is everything all under control. You know, there's actually two Christmas stories, one in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and then there's another one, Revelation 12, where it talks about what's happening in heaven when Satan is thrown out of heaven. When the woman gives birth to the child, and we see the devil then coming on earth because you know his time is short, but they overcame him, as Revelation 12:12 says. Actually, Revelation 12:11 says they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, the word of their testimony. They not love their lives unto death. You may be one of those feeling that all-out attack from Satan. Get that testimony of Jesus deep in your heart. Know that He loves you. Let His power flow through you. And don't be afraid of getting involved in other people's needs. Reaching out, that's what Jesus told us to do. And that's why we want to feed those that are hungry and shelter those that are homeless in every way that we can. And we thank God for those of you that are pledging and making it possible for us to help those in need. And we just praise God. Here you are, sister. You did some shopping earlier too, didn't you?
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
God bless you. And how are you today?
Hi.
And what is your name? Let's see, you have a little form there for me.
Okay. I'm Morticia.
Uh-huh. And are you facing some needs right now?
Yes, eating. I just moved and everything, so it's kind of lightheaded now, but God is good.
A lot of people have to choose between heating and eating, aren't they?
Yes.
Do I have to have enough money to pay the utility bills, enough money to pay the rent?
Yes.
And then try to get enough together to eat. So that's why we're trying to help the people. And I thank God for those who are donating New Life Evangelistic Center. We put together these food bags,
uh-huh.
right?
Uh-huh.
Earlier you had a chance to shop over there from all the produce and stuff they laid out.
Uh-huh.
And now they're giving you some bags of chicken and bacon and pies and bread.
It's a blessing. It's a blessing.
And we thank God for those of you that are a part of the blessing.
For each hand we hold, gathered round this table. From far and near we travel home, blessed that we are able. Grateful for this sheltered place, with light in every window.
Some blankets, which I'm just have to deal with what I'm dealing with, you know, till I can do better.
Well, Will, if people's heaters off, we even try to send teams out to their home to try to help them and get them blankets and heaters, and we're going to get you some food right now. What kind of need are you facing?
Utilities and rent and food.
Having to choose between heating and eating, right?
Heat and eat.
Well, let's even get you some food here. And again, those who don't have any heat on, we've been trying to send teams out to their homes to help them get some heat together. But we need you all to please continue to pray for us at this time here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And Sam's here helping me, Sam. And so let's get these folks some bags here, okay? All right, ladies, come right up here. Sam's going to try to help you there. And how are you? What kind of needs are you facing during this holiday season?
I need some heat, baby. I ain't had no furnace in 2 years.
Wow.
So
well,
I'm burning my electric heat in my ass.
All right. Get your name on our list over there. Right. And let's talk to this man over here and see if somebody can come to your home, okay?
All right.
And get you some blankets and a heater. And some plastic, okay? Can we do that?
Yes, sir.
In the meantime,
who I talk to?
In the meantime, okay, we'll have you talk to Brother Dave or Brother Ray, okay?
Okay.
Before you leave today, and then we'll try to get somebody over to visit you. Is that all right?
All right, that's fine.
And in the meantime, let's get you some food, okay?
Okay, thank you very much. May God bless you, too.
And thank you, folks.
I hope you get what you want. Everybody try to strike you down, but it's all right. Well, God going to lift you up.
We're just standing in the Word of God. I just want to do the work of God. I just want to do the work of God.
Oh,
just want to feed the hungry and shelter the homeless and reach out through the love of Jesus.
All right.
And we're going to keep doing it as long as you folks stand with us and pray with us. We're going to fight the good fight. He says, those that remain faithful to the end, so the same shall be saved. And that's my desire and that's my wish, the determination to stay faithful to the end for the glory of God. So many people in need.
Yeah.
What a blessing you are to help them.
Hello, my name is Connie McGall. I was homeless and I have nowhere else to go, but you guys helped me. And I was very, very grateful. And now I'm in a stable place and you're still helping me. And I appreciate everything that you guys have done for everybody that's homeless. Because everybody needs help sometimes. You know, it's just the way it is. I needed some help. It's Christmas, it's the Thanksgiving, and I need a little extra help. I'm not working. I am working a little bit, but it's not helping enough, and I just needed a little more help. I am thankful to be here. My mother died not too long ago, and I think, and a friend of mine's in this building just died 3 days ago. I am thankful every day. I am 50, I'm seeing my age. I'm 54 years old. I am thankful every day that I am here. God has delivered me from everything. And I am very thankful for New Life Evangelist Center. I want you to help me be stronger and do more and help people like you guys have helped me. I do feel like the New Life Evangelist Center should not be discontinued because they're helping everybody around that does not have nothing. And it's cold. People need help. Do not discontinue New Life Evangelist Center. Please do not shut it down. Please.
My name's Deborah Bowles, and I've been in the New Life family for many years. And they have helped me a lot throughout my life. I lost a lot. And I lost a lot of my health. I thank God every day because God takes nothing for granted. I am very, very, very lucky to still be here. That's why I don't take nothing for granted. And like I said, I've been in the New Life Evangelistic family for a long time. I have even been to Reverend Rice's house, me and my kids when they was little. And we went to Jefferson City, and he has helped a lot of people in this city, and I am one of them. I was blessed, but I always had a roof over my head, and it was a time when I didn't, when I lost everything in a fire, and I'm still here. So I'm grateful because I'm still here. So that's pretty much my life. But like I said, I am very blessed because I'm still here. And for anyone that needs help, you need to call them because they will come and help you. They have helped me throughout my life. This is not the first time. It's probably about the third time. I ain't sure. But today is my birthday. And I turned 60. So, believe me when I say I am very blessed to still be here. And I want to thank Reverend Ray and Reverend Rice for continuing to help people like me.
So many people, so much hurt, so much need. But we have to help people that are in need. You know, so many people sit back and criticize the anger that people are feeling right now, criticize the protesters because they're speaking out. But when people are hurting, they're going to get loud. They're angry. And New Life Evangelistic Center is providing an alternative, and that is the direct help, the food, the shelter, the assistance when people are in need. You need to step forward to help New Life Evangelistic Center during this Christmas season and share that much-needed Christmas gift now. I know you believe in God, don't you? Then let His light shine through you. Jesus said, as often you've done to the least of these, He said, even so you did it unto me. You can share that gift with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. How important is the help you're getting today?
Very important.
Facing a lot of need, are you?
Yes, I am, financially, mostly.
All right, we're going to get you some food right now. Utilities still on?
Yes, they're still on.
Okay, very good, because we're sending teams out to try to help those that are off, okay?
All right.
But you keep praying now.
I keep praying.
Christ is risen. Don't give up. You're facing problems. Add a whole lot of zeros, and you'll see what I'm facing, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Just keep praying for me. And what's your first name?
Gwendolyn.
Gwendolyn. God bless you, Gwendolyn.
Yeah, a couple of years I used to live here.
Did you?
Yeah.
So now you're on no place, so thank God for that, right?
Yeah, thank God for
that. Well, come over here and get some food, Gwendolyn. He'll give you a bag there. Hi, how are you?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm fine. What is your name?
Earl Jordan.
How are you doing?
I'm okay.
What kind of needs are you facing?
Well, I just moved, and I have a very huge gas bill. My gas is off right now.
It's off now.
Yes, it is, and I got some work on it, but I'm in desperate need of a heater.
All right, we need to talk to David over here, the man right there, and get your name on the list, and people will try to come out and visit you.
Thank you.
I see you filled out one of these forms. He said, I want to see 1411 Locust stay open.
Yes,
I do. I'm going to pray.
I do.
I'm going to contact the mayor of St. Louis to demand equal representation among the directors of the city of St. Louis departments. I mean, here the Board of Public Service has one African-American they put on in February. The man's been in office 14 years. 48% African-American. He doesn't appoint any to real leadership. So people are going to contact and talk about the possible closing of 1411 Locust Shelter and impact it'll have on the greater St. Louis area on social media.
You got to have another with something to replace
it. You're going to see it. Amen. Well, thank you for standing with us. More and more people are standing with us, and God bless you. Come see him about your utilities over here, okay?
Thank you.
Yes, the Lord bless you. Yes, sir. How are you today? What kind of needs are you facing?
That's financial needs, mostly financial, and that's why.
So the food going to be a help to you?
Oh, yeah, the food going to be a help. I got my grandkids. I got people coming over. You know, it just helps everybody else when I cook.
Yes, and we need your help right now. People are going to eat food even before Christmas. We're asking you to please share your Christmas gift now with New Life Evangelistic Center. It's on the front lines, helping, reaching out when people are hurting. It receives no city, state, or federal dollars, no United Way dollars, because it's a grassroots organization of caring people. We'll come right over here. God bless you. How are you today?
How are you doing?
What kind of need are you facing today?
Oh, I'm looking for a job.
Are you really?
Yes. Because I was working out there at Ferguson, Florissant District, but you know, it's too much racket. I've been shot at and everything coming through there with the school district.
Wow.
Yeah.
A lot of people in need right now. A lot of anger out in the streets in there.
Yes, it is.
And we're trying to address that. They shut this place down. There'll be more anger, won't they? People have no place
to
go at night.
They better not shut it down, right.
I mean, here, it's unbelievable what the city mayor wants us to do. He wants us to keep people two blocks away from the place, okay?
That's right.
That's partly because of negotiation. No, we've negotiated to try to help, but they're coming up with such unreasonable demands.
Right, exactly, which they shouldn't do it because the homeless need home to stay, shelter, they need food and everything else, and it's time for giving.
And we're trying to stop anger and riots by providing a direct service, and they keep feeding more and more of it out there, and then going to call out the National Guard and more police officers.
That's right.
Something's wrong in this area, so please go to God in earnest prayer.
That's
please
right.
pray. Don't give up. Give it to God. Well, come on over, sister. We got some food over here for you. Yes, and he'll help you get a bag of food right here. And God bless you. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. How are you today?
Okay.
What kind of needs are you facing?
The support right now.
Oh, yeah.
God, I need coats and boots, stuff like that.
Amen. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, you want to visit our free store when we're done here, okay?
Okay.
And go down and take a look down there, okay?
Okay.
See if you can find some of that. We're praying that people will bring us more. And may God bless you in a very special way, all right?
Okay.
Thank you. Merry Christmas. Come right on up here. There are many, many people facing many needs right now, and New Life Evangelistic Center is working to be there.
How you doing? My name is Roger Sims. I'm here with one of the representatives of New Life Evangelistics. I'm here to tell you about how much they helped me out with my winterization. As you see, I got my packet and my stuff, and I really needed it, to be honest. I just moved into my apartment. I've been here for 2 months, and got my heat on, and my stuff just seeps out all my windows, and I have to keep my heat on like 85 degrees just to keep it like a 75 degree temperature in the house. But by me having the supplies that they dropped off to me, I'm able to get up there and fix, you know, put plastic around my windows to reserve and take my heat down, so I don't have to, my bill don't have to be so high. I'm also here to talk about that I believe that you should keep them open. They helping people like us all around in the St. Louis City area and over in East St. Louis to get things like this done. I'm a less unfortunate guy. You know, I've been to the penitentiary. I got felony, I don't have no job. I got Section 8, and I need this type of program for people out there to help me like that. And if y'all take that away from me, we won't have this type of assistance, you know, and I need it, you know. So please keep them in mind and keeping it together, because I never know what I may need them or not, or nothing like that. As far as the service and the things that goes on with evangelistics, I think they service pretty well. When I talk to them, it's pretty good and decent. You know, they respectful. They always trying to make sure that I have everything that I need and on the right time. They always calling and preparing. And as far as the service, going to church service and stuff like that, they very, very good in that too. I like that. I go there a couple services times. I am thankful because I am 31 years old. And I have a felony, and I'm on Section 8, and I got my first apartment for myself in my name, like mine. I'm happy for that. I'm grateful and thankful. I'm also grateful that I have a chance that I can have somewhere to bring my son and can spend the night. You know, we got some food that we can eat. We can sit down and watch TV. We can do things together. So I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful that they gave me my winterization, because I have been here 2 months and I haven't had my son over because he don't take kindly to the cold air. So I'm able to get my son back, and he's gonna be able to come and see me. And I'm thankful just because God give me breath every day to breathe. And I don't want God to do anything for me in the near future. God has blessed me a lot. Whatever he wants to do for me, I will accept that. I will, but if I had to ask for him to do something in the future, I would ask him to look out for those that who need help, like evangelistics. Right now, they need our help to keep them open. So I would ask them that, for y'all to look out to keep them open so they can help people like me that's in need, or people that's out there in the world that, you know, just need guidance or, you know, counseling or help, or with a abuse situation, violence, jobs, anything. I mean, they are a very big help to the world.
What is your name?
Annette.
What kind of needs are you facing?
I need shelter. My daughter.
Yeah. Do you really? Well, you come down here at 3 o'clock. We'll try to get you checked up for it, okay?
Okay.
And keep praying for us.
Thank you.
Because, like I said, we're encountering a lot of trials and tribulations right now. Mm-hmm. We're going to try to keep this shelter open. We can't leave this woman, her daughter, and others out on the street. And I'm asking you to please help us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. There are so many people that are in need. What kind of needs are you facing?
All needs. I don't have one of anything, and need two of everything.
I hope you're taking them to Jesus.
Yes, sir. I sure
am. Taking them all to Jesus?
Yes, sir.
Day by day, hour
yes,
by
sir.
Hour?
Day so by day. One day at a time.
I have to take them to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Man, what kind of need are you facing?
I need a place to stay.
Do you? Don't play. They have a place. A lot of people losing it these days, aren't they?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, the city should be working with us to try to get shelters open in St. Louis County and St. Charles, rather than trying to crush the last remaining one that's open. I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, and just go to God in earnest prayer. We need your prayers at this particular time. What kind of need are you facing, ma'am?
I just moved, and the only thing that we need now is just a mattress and box spring.
Okay.
We got everything else, but we need a mattress, box spring, and a washer and dryer. That's it.
Why don't you talk to Sam or David over here about that, okay?
All right.
So many hungry people, so many hurting people, so many people in need. Thank God for the blessings he's given you. Yes, we celebrate the birth of the Christ child. And let's do it by remembering what he said, that the birthday gifts we can give him is to reach out and help those that are in need. What a big difference you make when you donate to New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. I thank God for those of you that are caring and sharing at this critical hour.
Hi, my name is Irene Kennard, and I'm 54 years old, and I'm married to Arthur Kennard. And the reason I had to come to New Life for some help, some assistance, is because our heat was cut off before the Coetterill, and it's a pretty high bill. So when it got real cold, you know, with the down to two wind chill factor, it was real cold. So now I'm sick. I got a sore throat, and I've already been in the hospital four times this year with pneumonia. And so that's why New Life Evangelist Center sends me out some plastic to put on my windows, so because it's really chilly in here, and some blankets and a heater, because it's been pretty hard for us. We sometimes have to go sit in the truck just to get some heat. And so, and then we're, you know, a little short on food, but thank God we got a microwave and electric stove. So then this food will help us, because I'm just grateful that y'all were here for us this time. And, excuse me. And I want to thank God, because I just feel as bad as I feel. I just so grateful. God just did, New Life answered my prayers, so we really need to keep them around. They need to stay down to me, because we go to Reverend Ray and them when we're really, really in hard times. And Arthur and I just been married 12 years, and so we was in the program. So I'm grateful for New Life. New Life has helped so many people. It's just not just us, but so many people that really, really needs the help, and they really come through for them. So we need to vote for them and petition and go down and call your congressman and everything and try to keep New Life around, because they just, and the prayers. Keep the prayers coming in for New Life. And Reverend Ray, thank you so much. Thank you, New Life. Reverend Rice, Chris, and your wife, just thank you so much for being there for us, because I just didn't know what we was going to do this time. But you really came through for us. Thank you so much. Like I just said, that I've been in the hospital five times this year. Four times is with pneumonia. And I have, my husband and I both have COPD. So it's very crucial that we needed this plastic and blankets and stuff, because the pneumonia, you know, you can die from pneumonia. And antibiotics, and I'm diabetic and high blood pressure, and my husband, he has COPD, and he has mental illness. So, but that's from, we're stressed, you know. So I have a degenerative disc disease, and I just want to get better. This has been a bad year for me, so I just need to get my health better. So prayers, prayer works. Help us with our health first of all, you know. Make us stronger so we can get up on our feet. Just keep us in this prayer, protect us. You know, my husband has a science, and he takes his arms out and holds us, you know. He's there for us in every way. So, and I believe it, he really is, because he's really coming through for us right now.
So many hungry people have been coming to New Life Evangelistic Center, and we're able to feed them and help them because of those of you that are praying and caring and sharing. Tell us some of the needs you're facing right now.
Well, my need is for food, utilities.
Food and utilities?
Managing, yes, and managing money, of course.
So you just didn't have to go around.
No.
There's a lot of frustrated people at this point that are releasing their frustrations on the streets, isn't there?
Yes, it is.
I think that people don't understand when you don't, your light, you have to choose between heating and eating and a place to sleep and stay, and then, you know, you wonder if your child might get in trouble or get shot out there. I mean, there's a lot of frustration and anger right now, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How does New Life Evangelistic Center help draw people together and cope with this?
Showing the care.
That's what's needed right now.
Showing the care. Care and love. Love. Yes, they show that they care, and once they feel that they care, they know they it being love.
Yes, and we're able to do that because of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center and are making such a big difference for good in the lives of so many hungry people, so many people getting help now because of those of you that are caring and sharing.
My name is Reginald Killian. I'd like to thank Reverend Rice. If I was to ever get an issue where I can get some money, I will help them. And that's on God's belief. I will help them. And I'd like to thank you for this heater. And I appreciate it. I'm thankful just to be living. I thank God for everything that I receive. And whenever I get capable of doing, I'm going to give back. Reverend Rice helped a lot of people. And if you call them down, something wrong with that picture.
Hi, my name is Cornel Franklin, and I'm here in my home at 4228 East Cook Street. And God has blessed me with meeting New Life Adventist Center. I've been dealing with them over the past 5 or 6 years. They've helped me tremendously in every way possible. I've also stayed in their shelter on and off, and was blessed with that. When it was cold, they let me in, and I was warm and fed and bathed, clothes. And I thank God for them. I'm just blessed. They came to my home today with my phone call, and it was answered. Put plastic to my windows, brought heater and blankets and food. I'm just thankful, and I just pray that they stay open and do more for other people that are in need. I'm sure they will, and God bless them. Thank you.
I thank God for each and every one of you that are standing with us during this great time of need. What a blessing you are in the lives of many, many people. You're making a big difference for good. There's a lot of hurt and a lot of pain out on the streets, a lot of hurt and a lot of pain. But God is there, and we're not giving up. We're going to give it to Jesus. We're going to keep looking to Him, aren't we?
Yes.
In the middle of it all. What kind of things are you facing?
Just everyday life, living.
How does your faith help you keep going?
Believing in God. Believe. Trusting.
You're not giving up?
No.
What do you do when your faith gets weak and you start wavering?
It's prayer.
Yeah, your prayer helps, doesn't it?
Yes.
I find myself, praying's like breathing to me, okay? You just have to pray. Pray without ceasing. Pray here, pray there. Pray everywhere. You may be facing some overwhelming needs. Don't give up. Give it to God. Know that God is in control. He's a great God. He's a mighty God. These are turbulent times. And these are difficult times. People living in fear. People living in worry. Satan just released on earth, as we read in Revelation 12:12. But greater is He who's in us than he that's in the world. He's calling His people out of Babylon, Revelations chapter 18, that great materialistic system where people living for themselves just buy and sell and buy and sell. It's all being destroyed as we know it someday. That's why we have to come to Jesus, don't we?
Yes.
Come to Jesus. Come to Him. He says, come to me, all you who labor, heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Let's abide in His rest. Let's abide in His peace. There's always something we can worry about, isn't there?
Yes.
Always something that can trouble us. Always something that can upset us. But let's come to Jesus and experience His peace that passes all understanding, and watch Him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think. If you need prayer, call us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Number's 436-2424. 1-800-334-3276. I want you to know that God loves you. He's got a plan for your life. Open your heart. Experience His peace, His grace, His mercy at this hour. And let Him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think. What a mighty God we serve.